As global temperatures warm and polar ice melts, sea levels are rising fast. Since 1900, global sea levels have risen between 16 to 21 centimeters. Though it doesn't sound like much, the phenomenon is accelerating. It's expected that sea level could rise by as much as 3 feet by the end of the century. Alongside other factors, like buildings sinking under their own weight, cities worldwide are at risk of disappearing from the map. We've already talked about some of these sinking cities in a previous video. If you haven't seen that video yet, click on the pop-up above. Since there are practically dozens of cities in danger of being underwater, we've made sure to look into the cities we haven't mentioned before. Before we begin, be sure to hit the like button to help us out. Now here are 10 sinking cities that will soon be underwater, part 2. Number 10. Charleston, USA. Breaking into the top 10 is a city with a long history of flooding. Charleston, South Carolina is a peninsula city, located on an inlet between the Ashley Cooper and Wando Rivers. Though the city is no stranger to flooding, it's been worsening in recent years, even more than you'd expect from sea level rise alone. Indeed, in a 5-year period ending in 2013, roughly 23 flood days occurred per year, a colossal jump from just 4.6 days in the 1960s. Subsidence or sinking land may be the culprit. That's left scientists scratching their heads for an answer. Around 5 of the past 12 inches of sea level rise over the previous 100 years is attributable to subsidence, but it's not obvious why the land is sinking. Charleston has always been a low-lying city, but scientists now suggest that with bigger and bigger buildings being built on the peninsula, the crushing weight of all that steel and concrete are compressing the underlying soil. With the 2014 National Climate Assessment already labeling Charleston as one of the cities most threatened by rising sea levels, something must be done fast. Number 9. Manila, Philippines. Surrounded on all sides by water, Manila is amongst the world's most densely populated and fastest-growing cities. Roughly 13 million people are squeezed into the small isthmus. Before the 1960s, the sea level around Manila hardly increased. Since then, however, the rise has been staggering. Floodwaters now devour the city, as sea levels rise, and the land around Manila Bay sinks. It's a disastrous combination. By 2050, it is estimated the sea will have risen another 50 centimeters, a rate 5 times faster than the rest of the world. For Manila's residents, it's an apocalyptic prediction. Already back in 2009, Typhoon Ketsana drowned the city in almost 7 meters of water. More than 80% of the city was underwater, displacing roughly 300,000 people. Part of the problem is the over-extraction of groundwater for drinking. The city is sinking at a rate of 10 centimeters per year. As one local bishop warns, the more water we extract, the more that we're sinking. If nothing is done, Manila may vanish beneath the waves. Number 8. Shanghai, China. In just 26 years, the Shanghai skyline experienced an insane transformation. From the low-lying houses and offices to the skyscrapers that now tower over the city, Shanghai is the poster child of the Chinese economic miracle. Now the colossal weight of the new buildings is beginning to sink. Even before the construction, Shanghai was sinking at 10 centimeters per year. But with the added weight and extensive groundwater pumping, the process is accelerating. Since 1921, the city has descended more than 6 feet. Sinkholes are now increasingly common, and the cracks are beginning to show. In one case, near the 101-story Shanghai World Financial Center, a blogger showed a 22-foot-long crack. Situated atop a floodplain, Shanghai's soft sedimentary soil is buckling. With rising sea levels also a major threat, Shanghai may become China's Atlantis. But with construction showing no signs of slowing down, the problem is only set to worsen. Number 7. San Francisco, USA. Standing atop the steep hillsides of San Francisco, it's hard to imagine the city is sinking. Yet like Shanghai, the staggering weight and density of buildings downtown are doing just that. Millennium Tower in particular has earned the nickname of the Leaning Tower of San Francisco due to its significant tilt. Most frightening was the large crack which appeared in the building in 2018 after a loud noise. But it's only the third heaviest building. Parts of the city, like San Francisco International Airport and Foster City, are sinking up to 10 millimeters a year because of underlying compression. With sea level rise also threatening the Golden City, an area of between 50 to 410 square kilometers could be underwater by 2100. Experts are now looking to other coastal cities for lessons on how to avoid catastrophe, but their prospects don't look good. After battling to save the Millennium Tower since 2014, the building is still sinking. In San Francisco, it seems the only way is down. Number 6. Osaka, Japan. For centuries, Japan's former imperial capital has been an economic and commercial hub, but it's also one of the world's port cities most exposed to coastal flooding. Lying on the edge of Osaka Bay, Osaka is home to some 19 million people, But if sea levels rise the 3 feet predicted, more than 4.1 million people could be at risk of flooding. Moreover, economists estimate that by the 2070s, the loss or damage from coastal flooding could exceed $1 trillion in assets. For the world's third largest economy, it's a daunting prospect. Even worse, parts of the city are also sinking. Japanese authorities plan to raise the height of the runway and taxiways at Kansai Airport's first airport island after significant flooding. As typhoons of increasing strength batter the airport, seawaters are beginning to flood the runways. That's despite building the airport to withstand storm surges up to 2.7 meters high. Further defenses like seawalls may also be needed, or else the next typhoon could overwhelm not only the airport, but the city itself. We're now halfway through our video. If you're still with us, comment sinking cities below. Number 5. Amsterdam, the Netherlands. The Dutch have long been famed for their mastery of the seas. Since the 1300s, the nation reclaimed thousands of square miles of land from the sea. Indeed, around 17% of the country's total land area is land reclaimed from either the sea or lakes. If the country's flood defenses failed, about 65% of the country would be underwater. As the saying goes, God created the world, but the Dutch created the Netherlands. The capital, Amsterdam, might be their finest achievement. Constructed using canals to control the sea, the entire city is around 2 meters, or 6.6 feet below sea level. Now, hundreds of years after its construction, the city is under threat. The underlying ground had long been sinking, but the costs of repairing and maintaining the city's infrastructure are growing and are expected to reach 5.2 billion euros by 2050. The city is already undergoing urgent repairs to stop it from collapsing into the water. Hopefully, the renovations will stem the rising tides, but whether Amsterdam is safe for good remains to be seen. Number 4. London, UK. At number 4 is a surprising entry. Unlike other cities, London isn't sinking due to skyscrapers or failing infrastructure. Rather, the global city is undergoing glacial isostatic adjustment. Behind the jargon, the concept is simple. Back in the last ice age, the vast weight of the glacier pressing down on Scotland caused the south of Great Britain to soar up. Since the glacier melted, the south is slowly sinking back down at a rate of 0.04 inches per year. Making matters worse is sea level rise. The Thames Barrier, a colossal set of floodgates at the entrance to the city, was created to protect London against tidal surges. It was expected they'd be used at most 3 times per year. However, they're being used 6 or 7 times a year. London could face a stark future as downpours intensify and sea levels rise. According to the Greater London Authority, 17% of the metropolitan area is at risk of high or medium floods, affecting around 1 million people. Sooner or later, the Thames Barrier may not be enough. Number 3. Honiara, Solomon Islands. While some cities are at risk of flooding, the Solomon Islands are being swallowed by the sea. For residents of the archipelago's capital, Honiara, it's a very real possibility. 5 reef islands nearby have disappeared from the island nation in a prophetic warning of what's to come. 6 more have been severely damaged by coastal erosion and rising sea levels. The island chain is home to around 640,000 people, of which 92,000 live in Honiara City. The Pacific has been rising by 7 millimeters per year around the islands, more than double the global average. Situated on the coast, Honiara is particularly at risk. But with the open ocean to contend with, little can be done to combat the rise. Nearby Taro, the capital of Choiseul Province, is set to become the world's first provincial capital to relocate due to rising sea levels. It's only a matter of time till Honiara is affected. Number 2. Rotterdam, the Netherlands. While its neighbor Amsterdam receives more international attention, Rotterdam is also succumbing to sea level rise. Europe's largest port and the second largest city in the Netherlands owes its entire existence to Dutch land reclamation. Indeed, as the name suggests, the city started life as a dam in the Rot, a river running through the country's southwest. Now, 700 years of work is being undone. Despite constructing a powerful new seawall in 1997, it becomes harder and harder to keep the waters out every year. What's worse, subsidence is causing the city to sink 1 to 1.5 centimeters per year. Roughly 20,000 houses will need work to deal with subsidence, with costs reaching up to $111,000 per home. Some aren't confident it will make any difference. The Netherlands' lowest point lies just to the east of Rotterdam, 22.2 feet below sea level, and 90% of the city is also below sea level. Unless rising tides can be curbed globally, more and more land will fall prey to the sea. You're nearly at the end of our video. We're on a mission to explore all of Earth's amazing destinations. Make sure you're subscribed. That way, you'll always be notified of our latest videos. Number 1. Victoria, Seychelles. In the Indian Ocean, paradise is being lost before our eyes. Seychelles, a magical tropical garden of Eden, won't be around for much longer. The capital of the 115-island archipelago is Victoria, situated on the main island of Mahé. 26,000 people out of the country's total population of almost 91,000 calls the city home. Already, beaches are shrinking as the land disappears beneath the tides. Like other island nations, such as the Maldives, it's only a matter of time until it's gone. As Ronald Jumeau, the Seychelles ambassador to the UN, questioned in 2010, what should the island residents worry about more, rising sea levels or the erosion of the islands as the coral reefs die? It's merely a question of which comes first. Hey, thanks for watching. Want to suggest a video or have something to say? Let us know in the comments section below. Check out our cities playlist for more videos like this one.